7:30.
CBS Sports presents the Prudential College Football Report. Sponsored by The Prudential, offering a full range of insurance and other financial services. The Prudential, the rock, it's strong, it's on the move, it's bigger than life.
Jim Nantz back in New York, the Prudential College Football Report. Boy, that Arizona team looks good as they're beating the Bruins 18-0 at halftime. Now, let's get you caught up on the scores. First of all, in baseball, in case you missed it, the Mets dramatically beat Houston at a 6-5. Craig Dykstra with a two-run homer, one out in the bottom of the ninth, and the Mets now lead in that best-of-seven series 2-1. Len Dykstra, of course, hitting that home run for the Mets in that game. Now, top 20, or top 10 in college football. Miami of Florida scored 21 points already in the first quarter. They're beating West Virginia handily, as expected, on the road. Miami looking good early. Some of the other scores, Alabama and Memphis State, third quarter, the Tide leading over the Tigers 20-0. It's a night game, Nebraska going against Oklahoma State. Michigan State and Michigan at halftime. They're just getting ready to start the third quarter, and Michigan leads it by 10. Penn State scored 9 points in the final 3.5 minutes to beat Cincinnati, and the Nittany Lions now 5-0 on the year. Oklahoma with 17 points in the first quarter against Texas in that annual showdown at the Cotton Bowl. Number 7, Auburn, 31-9. In fact, the Tigers scored 2 touchdowns in the first 66 seconds. Here's one of them, Brent Fullwood, who will take it 38 yards. Fullwood, 7 carries, 145 yards. That's 20 yards a carry. And Auburn easy over Vanderbilt today. Arkansas and Texas Tech now at halftime. Arkansas was trailing early, but they tied it with a second quarter touchdown. USC and Washington State scoreless as that game's just underway. Iowa and Wisconsin. Now, Wisconsin, the Badgers, given Iowa a much more difficult time than anyone would have thought. Yesterday, the Dallas Morning News reported that Hayden Fry will replace Fred Akers at Texas next season. Fry has denied that report.
You know, that's ridiculous. You got to let some clown down in Texas write an article, and you guys spend all your time on something. I wouldn't give that guy the time of day down there. And Fred Akers trying to get ready for a big ball game with Oklahoma, that's ridiculous.
But all the people around Iowa, I mean, they're just...
Tell them I'm here in Iowa. I'm not going any place.
10-6, Iowa, third quarter over Wisconsin. Now, other games involving ranked teams. Texas A&M over Houston. The Aggies winning in Houston for the first time in 12 meetings. They win it by 12. Number 15, Arizona State and Oregon. That game just underway in the West. Georgia Tech with their highest point total since 1957 when they scored 59 against Presbyterian. Here's the big story. Jerry Mays, who threw this touchdown pass, and he ran for 3 other scores. And 188 yards rushing on the day for Mays. He's only a sophomore, and an amazing day for him as Tech hands the Wolfpack their first loss of the year. In the East, Maryland and Boston College in a surprise. The Eagles beating the Terrapins 23-7 fourth quarter. They've just started that fourth quarter. Pennsylvania and Brown, a battle of unbeatens in the Ivy League. Penn shutting out Brown in the fourth. In the South, Army and Tennessee. That is now a final as Army has scored in the final minute to now beat Tennessee 25-21. That's a big upset. Army now 3-2 on the year, and the Volunteers fall to 2-3. Kentucky hasn't lost this year. They may today as they trail Mississippi at halftime. Kent State and Florida. Florida pouring it on today for their second win of the year. In the Midwest, Indiana and Ohio State were tied, but the Buckeyes have scored 10 points in a row. Kansas and Iowa State. Kansas with a 10-0 lead. The Jayhawks right now riding a 3-game winning streak. Other scores in the West, Air Force and Navy. Air Force leading by 20 in the fourth quarter. Wyoming and Utah, and Wyoming with a 7-point lead. The Utes are winless this year, and they've given up an average of 49 points a game. New Mexico and UTEP, 14-3. The Lobos lead it in the second quarter. And still ahead of us here at halftime, we'll talk with head coach Ted Tollner of unbeaten USC, and we'll update that baseball playoff story. Of course, more scores and highlights as the Prudential College Football Report continues here on CBS with results from around the country.
It's a jungle. That's how it feels when you're searching for life insurance. The natives don't speak your language. You feel lost, in the dark, scared. But there is a sign of civilization. With Prudential, your agent will explain things clearly and work with you until you have a piece of the rock you feel comfortable with. No wonder more people choose Prudential for life insurance than any other company. You'll feel right by the rock. Prudential Life Insurance.
An investment firm is only as impressive as it is responsive.
It's
ago.
So when interest rates fell, we looked for new ways for our clients to make money and developed unique opportunities like the Prudential Real Estate Investment Trust, a first of its kind in a way to take advantage of changing markets. While others may imitate it, we're busy surpassing it. If anyone can show you bold new thinking in the business of making money,
let's close it.
It's Prudential Beach, rock solid, market wise.
Well, the Irish of Notre Dame are off to their worst start since 1962, and they lost it once again on a missed last-second field goal. John Carney, this time, from 38 yards with 18 seconds to go, he missed it, and Pittsburgh holds on to beat the Irish, and Notre Dame now 1-4 on the year. Purdue and Illinois, a late touchdown there, a three-yard run by Ray Wilson with a minute five to go, won it for the Illini against Purdue. Colorado wins their first game of the year. They beat Missouri. More trouble for Weidenhofer. They're now 1-4. In the South, North Carolina outscored Wake Forest, and the Tar Heels, look out for this team. They are now 4-0-1 on the year. Their quarterback, Jonathan Hall, threw four touchdowns. Virginia Tech and South Carolina, 27-all tie. Scott Hagler missed a 40-yard field goal for South Carolina with 6 seconds to go. Another heartbreak for the Gamecocks. You remember last week, they almost upset Nebraska. In the East, Cornell over Harvard, 3-0. And for Harvard, that's the third week in a row now they've been shut out. That's the first time it's ever happened to the Crimson. Once again in baseball, the Mets with a ninth-inning win against the Astros, 6-5. New York now leads in that best-of-seven series, 2-1. After the game, Brent Musburger was there to talk with Darryl Strawberry of the Mets.
Darryl Strawberry and Darryl Strawberry Jr., that was a terribly exciting win by the Mets.
Yes, it was a very exciting win. We battled back. We were down 4-0, but we had a lot of confidence, Brett. We felt that we were going to come back in that ball game. And I'm just pleased the way things turned out for us, and it was a big win for us, and we look forward to tomorrow's ball game.
You really can hit left-handed pitchers. Three-run homer off a good one.
Well, you know, Nepper's, he's tough on all left-handers, and it was just a situation I was in, and I was looking for a certain pitch, and I got the pitch, and I did what I had to do with it.
Did you think Dykstra's homer was out there?
Oh, yeah, I feel good about it, because when he hit it, I jumped up, and I was screaming. I said, that ball is out of here. And, you know, Lenny, he's not a home run hitter, but if you make a mistake on him, he can't take you out the ballpark.
Young man, what'd you think of Daddy's home run? Was it pretty good? It was that exciting, huh? Are the Mets going to win this? Darryl, he's like Steve Carlton.
He don't want to talk to the press right now.
Thanks, Darryl.
All right, Brent.
Okay,
thank
babe.
All right, 6-5, the Mets win it. They lead it 2-1. And when we come back, we'll talk with a head coach who's restored a former national power to prominence this season. He's Ted Tollner of Southern Cal, and you're watching the Prudential College Football Report here on CBS, where the scores continue from around the country.
Find the holes in your homeowner's insurance before they find you.
Sorry to barge in.
Have a Prudential representative give you a fast, free pre-review of your coverage.
Are we covered?
And this?
If you had a pre-review, you'd know.
Get a pre-review from the Prudential and get a piece of the rock.
Doesn't look like Bermuda to me.
Powerful new financial help is coming. The Rock, the Prudential, is now more than insurance. It's mutual funds, home mortgages, IRAs, stocks and bonds, new products and new ideas. It's rock-solid financial help for us all. The Rock, the Prudential. It's strong, it's on the move, it's bigger than life.
As we approach the midway point of the season, one of the big surprises has been Southern Cal. They're in the top 10, they're unbeaten, and their coach in his fourth season is Ted Tollner, who finally appears to have silenced his critics out there in Los Angeles. Coach Tollner, welcome to the Prudential College Football Report.
Thank you, Jim. It's a pleasure to be on the show.
Now, obviously, there's a lot of pressure involved with that USC job, but a lot of people don't realize you've won more conference games in your tenure than any other Pac-10 coach, but you still come under fire. Do you think that's fair?
I really do, Jim. You know, USC has great expectations, and we have very high goals. And I think when you do, there's some risk involved. We have not accomplished everything we want to accomplish here, and so you're going to be involved in some criticism. That's just part of it.
Coach, there was also inside criticism, a well-documented run-in with the athletic director. How did that affect your team? Has it affected your team at all in the way you've coached?
No, we're trying to win football games, and everything we do is with that focus in mind. And our players are fired up and ready to play. We're very excited about where we are right now, and that's all that we care about.
How about this team? I know it's one of the youngest teams you've ever had. Do you think that might creep up and hurt you at the end of the season down the stretch?
Well, we're going to find out. You always get concerned when you have so many young people that are touching the football. Rodney Pete is a very mature sophomore quarterback, but he's a sophomore. We're going to start Aaron Emanuel at tailback, and he's a sophomore. You know, so you get concerned. We have an all freshman and sophomore defensive line, and you get concerned. But they're a very eager group, and we do have some maturity at some of our older guys. So I think the mesh, if we can continue to develop, give us a chance to really make a run for the roses.
You, an ex-quarterback yourself, you tutored Jim McMahon at BYU. Just how good is this Rodney Pete as a sophomore?
Well, he's exciting, Jim. He has tremendous poise. You know, when we were down at Baylor, he went a streak of 3 for 16, and a young sophomore on the road can just come apart. But when he had to make some plays in the last two drives, he went 7 for 9, and we win that game down there on the road in a rainstorm, and then he had a great game against Washington, and last week against Oregon, he had a fine game. He has tremendous potential because of his poise, his passing ability, and most of all, his ability to run the football. He really stretches the field and opens up all phases of our offense.
All right, Coach. Good luck to you the rest of this season out there at USC.
Thank you much, Jim.
Ted Tollner, the coach of the Trojans. They're 4-0, and we'll continue with second half action coming up. This is the Prudential College Football Report on CBS.
The Prudential College Football Report has been sponsored by The Prudential, offering a full range of insurance and other financial services. The Prudential, the rock, it's strong, it's on the move, it's bigger than life.